let's jump into teams back at it again. So you've seen both of these teams. DTI winning the previous battle. EU1, the Russian team, or from the house of the DTI as well, so the same names. And versus Eden, also EU1. So we have EU1 tournament. On the contrary, for the nationality, they're mixed nationality, right? So maybe there are some Russians there as well, I don't know. They are both from the same house, same server, DTI house, Eden house plus couple of friends. So they are both aiming for the first place. As I said early, they have actually achieved quite a lot for their servers. So DTI have took the Conqueror City twice, Reginopolis as well. Eden actually was fighting for over 3 seasons for all the objectives, main objectives as well. So definitely very experienced guys. But let me tell you something more interesting actually. So did you know that from DTI lineup, the youngest player had 16 years, right? He's 16 years old, but the oldest player, Derevny, he has 54 years. So quite experienced guy. For the Eden team, on the other hand, we have 19-year-old Ohydra and 33-year-old Rasputin. So let's see if this additional 21 years of experience on the Derevny from DTI will be something that will allow DTI team to win. Maybe the thing that will be changing the output of the game. For the ranked battle score, the highest player from DTI team is Socialist Hippie. He has over 2,300 points. But for the other team, Eden team, you have Ghostex. He has 2,614 ranked points. Bladeshot, 2,600 points as well. And Viriato, almost 2,600, like 20 away. So three guys, 2,600 ranked points. So quite interesting thing. On the other hand, when it comes to units and hero skills, that is something different. Socialist Hippie, on average, 10 hero kills per siege battle. Viriato, from the Eden team, he has 5.1, so it's almost double. But the unit kills, the average unit kills, so the how many troops the given player killed across all season. For the DTI, Derevny, 150. For the Eden team, you have Bladeshot with 109. So definitely very experienced players. And to remind you, highlight players, Paptime for DTI and Viriatio for Eden. We are ready with the game, as you can hear in the background. So we will be jumping back to that. Let me quickly check if we have the teams done properly. So DTI is the revenue player and he is on the left. So I need to switch the teams quickly. So this is Eden, this is DTI. Bada bim, bada boom, and here we jump right into the game. So, when it comes to weapons, again, full on heavy armor, one longbow, exactly the same what they played in the first battle. If I recall correctly, DTI played, yes, all the attackers won, so DTI played attack, so they are on attack once more. On the contrary, Eden team, they played attack, right now they are in the defense, and they are opposite in the terms of the weaponry. Look at that. 1, 2, 3, 4 spears and 2 light armor, short bow and dual blades. So 6 non-high heavy armor might be different things. Go with and go DTI. Nice. I like the peace participation, guys. Sorry if I missed any of your questions. We'll have a break later on in the tournament so we can talk later on. Exclamation mark help. All the commands, all their rules, maps, prizes, betting information, everything you can see over there. And right now we are jumping into the game. Let's do something we didn't do earlier because starts are pretty... Actually, no, look at that! look at that. We have no time to look at anything. The cavalry rush, the counter of trebuchet is coming in, but it will not be enough. They will miss. Look at the full on cav, the full on cav. Oh my god, the identity, what they have done here. The cavalry push. They are cleaning, trying to clean up all the units, but the attacking side, look at that. Pikes, place them in the circle. Guy, you are attacking. Oh my god, they are attacking you from behind. Here, nice turtle. It will not be destroyed. This type, not too many cavalry, but here, look at that, the full on defense from the attackers. The attack turned into the massive defense. They are milking the circles out of the shields. They are bracing their shields, spikes and everything. And the attacking team right now, Eden team, the defenders, attacking from every direction. Look at that, so many cavalry. Iron Cap Scout Cavalry, few of those. And Arminger Lancers. Nice lineup. And they have cleaned, look at that, they have cleaned so many of the... They're capping their supply point. Is it gonna be a troll game? Are they just gonna clear the supply point of them and just not let them even enter the castle? Oh my god, there is some defense left here. 8 people from the DTI team are left alive right now. Let's look at the losses quickly. The attacking team, they have lost 400 units. The DTI team, 400 units left. On the other end, Eden team, 160. Here you can see 160 units left. Look at that, they are spawn camping them. They are killing. Oh my boy. What the? Oh my. What is happening? Look at that. Remember, only 3 lives per player. Each player have only 3 lives. And as you can see, most of the team of the DTI have already died at least once. And DTI, oh my god, you have lost so much. Let's see if they will be able to get back from it. Okay, seems like they have restructured. Seems like they calmed down. They said, guys, we are live streamed. We are having over 200 viewers right now. Live, they are watching us. They are betting on us. 200 for English viewers, over 150 German viewers. We cannot do it like that. Regroup, calm down, let's do it. And they have regrouped. Believe me, they did. Look at that, they are preparing the counter push. But the defenders of Eden are ready for that. Look at that, they used so much time. And DTI tried to counter push them through the gate. Only thing that is open right now is the gate. Eden opened gate, walked out of the gate, walked back in through the gate. And DTI tried to follow. But very nicely prepared from Eden. They have staged their retreat. As you have seen, not everyone from Eden have retreated. Some players retreated, and the ones who retreated early, they actually prepared the defense. So no counter push could be done. These guys over here, look at that. So many died here. Amazing. Very well played. Okay, seems like we are back to the standard. Standard thing coming in, so. Towers pushing, nothing happening. DTI learned their lesson. They have a lot of pikes, shields and everything. Main gate, they will not allow any more of this happening. Yeah, Destroyer, I didn't expect this strat either. Amazing, amazing game. Let's hop up to the bigger view right now. Let's look what's happening. Probably the same thing will happen again. So the push, the gate is closed for now. So it's another choke point blocked, and the attackers have the two entrances available. The B-side tower and this tower here. And they are slowly moving in. Before the whole action concludes, let's look at the stats one last time. 954 units left on the attacker side on DTI, 500 units died. A lot died. On the defenders, Eden, 1000 left, 200 died. Quite a lot available. When it comes to the heroes on the other end, no one from Eden died. No one. And remember, you have only 3 lives. The contrary, from DTI, 13 deaths. That might be crucial when we come to the later stage. So they come in, similar thing we have seen from the previous battles. They go in and they just fake attack on A, and they fully on transition to the B point. But Eden, they are prepared. I'm sure they have watched other streams, they have seen what other teams they have done. I'm sure they have watched both teams, I imagine, watched other teams playing, so they know what they can expect. And most of the teams are attacked here from the behind, so they had some time to prepare. Let's see how well they prepared. Quickly check on the A point. Very good rotation. Only two players left here. 2 versus 1, so good numbers. Most players here, most fight happening here. Let's switch to the slow mode. Attacking team from DTI, they are trying to work with the flanks. So the flank is covering here, trying to push a little bit. Nice trebuch, very nice trebuch in the back of the defenders. If the defender is looking into that direction, you cannot watch the trebuchet coming in. You have to be informed by other players from your team. If they tell you, good. If they don't, you lost a lot of units. That's what happened here, I think. The communication was not clear enough here. But resources are flowing in, the supply is coming in. Still, the supply point, if it's red, the red team can still use it. So they can heal, they can exchange units, replenish ammo. If it's orange, then it is inactive, so it is contested. For now, it's still active, so we can see, seems like it is defended. A lot of people's very low HP here, retreating, look at that. Seems like the Eden team were very prepared, and they are pushing out the attackers. 4 minutes left, 420 minutes left. A lot of deaths happening on both sides. Very heavy clash. Attackers from DTI nicely stopped the counter push. Look at that. Blocking the counter push with their trebuchets. And this is actually very effective. Most of the shields destroyed. Eden team, you should watch out for this trebuchet smart. It's the second time the trebuch kills quite a lot of units. You need to look out for this a bit more. And right now, very small force of the DTI left here. Seems like the attack is over. They have just 4 minutes. Just 4 minutes to regroup, prepare the next attack, and try to contest something. So let's go back to the high view. Let's see what they are going to prepare. Let's think a bit from DTI point. What they have done? They tried A. They were very... Like, they moved to the A. A was defended. So they switched to B, but B was also defended. What you can do? B, A, B, A. No one knows. Me personally, I would try to split some forces, go some B, some A. They have view inside, right? These guys here, Robert Disable and Leowin, they have very good view on what is happening inside. So they should tell their commander or their players. Guys, they have a lot of players on A. B is clear. Let's try to move like 8 players to A, but let's have a lot of players also contesting B. Because, yeah, it will be hard to push here with 3 minutes only and no cannons and no golden era units. Let's see for the statistics before the battle starts. Like the final push starts. 600 units left for DTI, 900 for Eden. It's gonna be hard for DTI, let me tell you that. On the unit and on the heroes, 20 deaths on the attackers, 5 on the defenders. So they are trying to do the same strategy, Jake. Move in and they rotate. But will they go B or will they go A? It's not known yet. They are moving from one side to other, from one side to other. And look at the amazing movement from Eden. They are transitioning, they are just following. They are mimicking the movement from the attackers. They are very nicely transitioning, right? So they move left, they move right, they follow them. And once more, the DTI pushing, Eden following. So very nice, but they missed their point a little bit. Some of the units from DTI are already downstairs, and we will see if this will be enough. There is just 2 minutes left. They don't have much time to think, to strategize. They need to brute force their way in something. It looks like the brute force is going to happen at both points at the same time. We have the Namcans coverage from top. The archers in the game, in the Conqueror's Blade game, the archers, if they are above, they have very nice damage buff, so they are doing a lot of work. Let's see if this will be enough. The shields are the only thing that is left right now on the B point for the defenders, but the reinforcements are coming. I see the charge is coming from the behind. Pikes, seems like the flanks from attacks from 3 different angles for the Eden will be enough to clear the B point, and the B point is over. There is no one left in the B point to fight on. All the remaining forces are pushing the A. Let's see if they will be able to do so. Only archers here, so I expect this game to unfortunately finish in 50 seconds. Most of the team for DTI is dead. Only 3 people are alive. Let's watch the people here. Uma, the archer. I don't think he will live too long with light armor. He's very fragile. As you can see, each shot is costing him a lot of health. Heimdall, he is trying to put some pressure on B, but it will not be enough. A lot of defenders are here. He doesn't have units. Nico Bishop. He is trying to run for his life. That's pretty much it. DTI, very good try. Nice rotations here and there. But I think that the first 5 minutes of the game, was crucial for the victory of the Eden team. Very well played, good game, amazing stuff. I really was not expecting this to happen. That is strategy, which is sometimes used on the sieges, when you can see if you go into siege with like 5 of your friends, all of you take horses and run out, you can kill a lot of players. I did not participate this to happen on the tournament like that. Amazing game. Let's go quickly through the information here. We actually have 17 minutes till the next game, so we can talk through the game a little bit more. And we can also talk about the rules, about the betting and few things later on. So, short break. When I watch your statistics, give me a moment to drink something. A very heavy game, since first second. By heavy, I mean intensive, of course. We can talk in a second on how this game went with you. So, as there is a 30 minutes, there is a short delay. Please write right now at me. Guys, at me. So basically, at me all your comments about this game. What did you like about the game? What you didn't like about the game? About this exact match, right? Write your comments and at me. I will read through the comments in a moment. Right now, let's jump to the team statistics analysis. So, DTI team, as you can see, a lot of dead people. They tried till the end. Very good work. But they have lost a lot of their key units on the beginning. And that was crucial. So, highlights. 83 kills on Felix. Good work. 84, 115 points of capture. These are the people, I imagine, who captured most of the bees. So, Montefel, Murzich, oh, DK. Good job, guys. Very well pushed. Was close, the B push, right? It could work. For the unit kills, yeah, 83. And for the hero kills, just a few. So nothing to highlight here. For the Eden on the other end, a lot of players over 100 kills. Look at that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 players. Half of the team over 100 units were killed. Thanks to the amazing cavalry charge at the beginning. Very, very good stuff. This is all the kills coming from, not only the units, but also the heroes. Look at that, 6 heroes, 6, 5. Oh my god, good work for Captain Long Ding Dong, Blade Shot, Lucostrel. Nice, the highlights of the hero kills, 4 unit kills, Blade Shot and Captain Long Ding Dong. Nice. Almost same stats. Blade Shot, Spear, 13 assists, very good work. Good spear player definitely over here. Remember that with spears, you can work with your cavalry well aware because spear player is the fastest on the horse. So, you see, when we started the game, I said, there is quite a lot of medium armor players. And they picked spears just to run out with the cavalry. Therefore, that was their tactic. Let's go quickly through the stats. So, the first 1 minute, look at that. Bam. Even first 2 minutes, right? First 2 minutes. So many deaths over here. So many deaths around this corner. This is something that was... Holy moly. Amazing stuff, let me tell you. Very good charge. Very good split as well. They dodged the trebuchets very well. They prepared this tactic very well. All the people were at correct places. So it was very well thought through. And very well executed, definitely, as well. So I can tell, great job, guys, great job on this one. Okay, the next game I need to prepare. One second. Okay. Okay, the next game. It's 30 minutes, so we have still some more time to talk. So this is definitely what won the game. Let's be real here, guys. This is definitely what won the game for Eden team. The push, the kills, unit kills especially, and a lot of crucial units have died for DTI. They didn't have the crucial units they planned for. The whole attack plan from DTA was heavily affected by this push, and this was amazing work. So later on, they tried a little bit to push on the gate. It was not possible. They then had to spend like one more minute to push the towers. That's what they did. And when they entered the fort, they walked on the walls. They tried to move to the B point. And in the B point, the push was there, but it was not enough. The defender team, one more highlight here from Eden. They reacted very, very well. They left only two players on A against one player from DTI. So very good rotation. And they had a lot of players to defend the B point. And that's what they did successfully. When we seen in the previous games, the plus was captured most of the time because the defender team did not rotate fast enough and they didn't have the numbers advantage, so they were just crushed with the numbers. Here it was the other thing. So they have bounced off, unfortunately, DTI with the attack here, and they retreated. And since that, with this push, they lost most of their units, I imagine, and there was no coming back from that. There was one more B push, which was nice. They captured some of the B, and that's where this participation on the DTI score, participation score comes in, and this was nice thing. All right.